Alrighty, hello and welcome to another episode of Pokemon Conquest. Now, I was supposed to record Baldur's Gate 3 today, and you might be like, well, why is this not a Baldur's Gate 3 episode? Well, you might hear it happen in the background of this video. My fans on my computer are going nuts, which doesn't quite make sense to me because it's fucking freezing in this room, and my computer is constantly overheating running this game. So I think if I turned on Baldur's Gate, right, I have to remember to play this. I think if I turned on Baldur's Gate, my computer would just implode. So I've elected not to do that. I just need to check everything, make sure there's nothing interesting showing up in them, which nothing interesting ever shows up here, but, my concern is that my computer would possibly just, like, blow up. I don't know. I don't know why it's like this. There's a setting on my computer called Nitro Boost, which... Nitro Boost, what it does is it means that, like, if you're playing a really, like, intensive game, it sort of, like, I guess removes limitations on the fan speed. This is it with Nitro Boost. So the limiters are off of the fan speed. And it's actually quieter than it is when it's not on Nitro Boost. And when it's not on Nitro Boost, it makes this horrible noise. Like a clicking and a clattering, and the fans are so fucking loud. So that's why I'm like, I should probably turn on Nitro Boost if I'm gonna record. And also, not play Baldur's Gate 3. Because when I was checking the temperature, it seems like for whatever reason, no matter what it is that I am running... Like, I could just open Steam, although something's wrong with Steam. Just opening Steam made the fans go fucking crazy and made the temperature go up to, like, 60-something degrees, which, that's a 10-degree jump from where it usually is. It's usually around, like a 53, 52 to 54, like, that's usually where it is. This started happening like a couple days ago, and I've been trying to sort it out, but the best I can do is turn on the Nitro Boost, which for some inexplicable reason actually makes the fans quieter. Sorry, so I'm just looking up like how to... Oh, darling. Do not make that noise. Okay. So I'm just checking to see, So it says that the thing should be gold as long as one warlord is present, but that's not true. The gold human head is just for one of the warlord's, like, second in commands. Okay. Okay, sorry, I was just Googling how to recruit these guys because it was starting to annoy me that I couldn't do that. So, problem is, I actually cannot recruit him here. So what I've got to do to recruit this guy, which... now here's a question. Oh, hang on, I can just send Ginchio over. You. I need you to... No. I need you to go up here, because if I don't have a... Right, it's X to confirm in this game, unlike every other one. But yeah, I've been... And my computer has been behaving... Period, end of sentence. It's been behaving. Okay, now that Genchio's here, I can actually recruit this warlord's assistant. Because the thing about the warlords and their assistants... I'm sorry, that was a terrible noise to make. Not directly into the mic, but probably very close to it. is apparently you can only recruit them. That was another terrible noise. I'm sorry. You can only recruit them with a warlord. So, I don't know. I don't know if, like, warlord assistants count because they also get the gold head. So, I'll just do my best to get it done with Gintia and nobody else. Which means I have to actually pay attention to which Pokemon. Okay, it was the Starly. So I'm gonna go here and hope. It's kind of all I can do. Let's try and bait it out with this fella. And then, yeah, send you over here. You can hear the fans are getting super loud again. Which usually at this time of year is when they get quieter, simply because it is currently kind of freezing in my room, right? So, so there is no real reason that the core temperature should be getting to this level. I'm not fully certain. Of course, Gingio is poisoned because she's our Cringevale queen. This was maybe a mistake. Everything about the way I did this, mayhaps, is a mistake, I think. But I really want to recruit this guy. Good, okay. He's moved into a slightly more accessible position, I think. If I can just move Machop. Okay, well, I guess I'll have to move it back. Oh yes, there's a wild. Really? You'd prefer a Mareep to your Shinx? Apparently Gintia would prefer a Mareep to her Shinx. Actually, I don't know that she'd prefer it. There's always a chance that it's an equal link with a Mareep. I suppose Ampharos is a really good Pokemon, to be honest. Though, was Ampharos a thing when this game came out? Yes. Ampharos must have been, because I believe the first Pokemon Ranger game is newer. Or older, rather, than this. And there was an Ampharos in that? I'm not fully guessing, just partially. I don't want that. Get up there. Make it hard for that Starly to move around. Actually, can I attack from... I can attack from down here. Wonderful. Oh. That's fascinating. Okay. Alright. Cool. Do not. Computer, come on. Come on. You can handle it. I believe in you. I have faith in you as a system. You can do it. You can make it. Okay. So, what I might do is I might try another little electrocute. Yeah, I'm going to electrocute these guys. I'm going to try moving Shinx so that Gintia's Shinx hits both of them as well. Shit, I can't do that? Okay. Just fuck this Starly up in specific. It also seems like... Are you fucking kidding me? It also seems like from my reading... Sure. Do that so that Gintia absolutely wrecks it next turn. From my reading, it does appear that... I didn't know that fighting was weak against poison. It does appear that you have to hit all of the requirements, not just like... whichever ones you feel like. Which does actually mean that if I do this now, I don't know that there's actually a way to hit both the Ekans and the Mareep, which is really what I want to do. I want to fuck both of them over, but looks like I can only do the one and also my Machop a little bit. In which case, why don't I just hit the Mareep? Because it really does seem to injure my Machop more than it injures the Ekans, so there's no real point in doing that one. Yeah, it's going to be the same thing there, so. Yeah, you know what? Fuck it. Get flung. Okay. So long as Gincho survives this, right? Oh, the accuracy's down. Woof. As long as Gincho survives this, but yeah, sorry, to recruit this, oh, it's super effective against Carnivine. To recruit this Starly, I believe I have to meet all of the requirements, not just like one. I have to do it in four turns, I have to do it with a super effective attack, and I've got to do it with Gincho here. Cool, Moodmaker is great, I love that. If I beat the shit out of this Mareep, like if I kill his Mareep, does the interference go away? Because that'd be nice. I would sure love that. Because it would be nice to like hit. Actually, let's see what I should have been checking. Warrior skills. Temperate's an interesting one. But okay. Gincho, please do your thing. Murder this Starly. Please? Yes, okay, you hit it. Seems the wind blows in your direction. Hopefully that means you're recruited now? Yes? YN? Yeah, sure. Fucks up the snake more than it fucks up my guy, I'll take it. Carnivine's tough. And I wanted that money. Okay. Does not seem that I can get him anywhere particularly useful. Also, that's a really bad warrior skill for an Igglybuff. I need to get you something that has, like, a... Oh my god. I think the only one who doesn't have accuracy down at this point might be this Igglybuff, to be honest. Shoot. It doesn't look like we're gonna get the Ekans or the other Mareep. It's fine if we don't get the other Mareep. It's the Ekans that I really wanted. But alas, I don't have any psychic types. Oh, you completely missed the fucking Mareep. Cool. Alright. Igglybuff is really bad. Ooh, at least it's not fairy type yet. Because fairy type didn't exist, so I can, in fact, hit it with my Venipede and it's not too bad. Oh my good god. Good golly. None of these bitches can accomplish anything. This Ekans is just surrounded on all sides. I sense this is not going well. Yeah, are the six Pokemon gathered around you not proof enough of that? Oh. Sorry about it, Sorin. I know that was your favorite. That was your bestest boy. Anyways, fuck you, Ekans. Also, 7 damage? Is that all you can do? No, you couldn't even do that. The enemy's competence is astounding. Does that mean you'll join me? Probably not. Okay. I can recruit the special guy with the Starly. Which, honestly, I just wanted him because he's special. I don't actually know that he's particularly useful. I already have a Starly somewhere. Although his favorite probably is not Starly, so it's probably going to be something else eventually. Let's see. So, right, I need water and grass types a little bit, but I also need... Well, I suppose I could send entirely water types with a single psychic or flying against that, and it would do. Oh goodness, Chrysalia is empty. I need to fix that. I need to fix that right away. I don't know what possessed me to leave it empty. Okay, where's the other one? You. Oh, and Illusio has a straight line to it. Woof. That would have been terrible. Okay. So it's the psychic types that have a direct line. And you know what? I need to start moving the fire types out of here. Because if we get attacked by a ground type enemy, that's not going to be ideal. I might keep Rufflet there. Although Terra also has a direct line to Chrysalia, which, whew, that was a mistake. That was a terrible, terrible mistake. So, okay. Terrera, I mostly need water types. Water and grass. So suppose what I can do, I want to move the Treecko, because I want the Treecko to evolve. You know what, okay. Let's delegate this one. Oh, you are training. Wonderful. You don't really seem to be getting stronger, but the Pokemon here are so weak that I'm not surprised. Okay, so I'm gonna march. I'm gonna march you and Sfeel over to Pugilis. I feel like, yeah, I would either have to attack Illusio, which I don't have a great grasp on. I don't have any dark types, which is my real big issue, I feel like. Okay, I've got to find strong enemies. Okay, Ignis is actually protected by having Pugilis in front of it. So if I take some of its stronger Pokemon and shove them in Chrysalia, which... I feel like the bug type area would also possibly have a couple of dark types in it, maybe? Maybe, I'm not sure. And you know what? I'm gonna move these two weak Pokemon over, because this kingdom is also fairly well protected by having, like, for them to march to that kingdom specifically, they would have to go pretty far. Okay. I'm actually gonna march the ugly monkey back because I don't care if that evolves. So yeah, send that someplace else. Send that to, just have to make sure I'm covering everything. Send that to Ignis, I don't give a fuck. And then yeah, march the two that I want to evolve over. To Chrysalia. Because everything else there is so tough that I suspect it won't matter that they have to kind of carry the team a little. Okay, this is a nothing burger. You've given me nothing to work with. I mean, I'll train them simply because... Oh, I didn't need to, but... Yeah, I really didn't need to train them, actually. None of these motherfuckers fly, so I can just have Magikarp chill here. Yeah, just wait out the battle, buddy. You're just here for the link bonus. And like, I don't care really if these guys... Yeah, of course you can't hope to compete. I don't really care if these guys are somebody's gold standard, to be honest. Like, I'll check just to be absolutely certain, but like, I already have a Sawaddle and a Venom guy. I don't remember the name of this Pokemon. Venipede? Oh, your move. Ooh, that's not a good thing. That your move is a normal. That's troubling, to say the least. Wonderful. As long as it doesn't attract Rico, I'm fine with whatever it does with its life. It's very irritating that you don't have a... I wonder if the better Starly has the correct typing. Yes, yes, up your defense and all that. Oh, shit, I crit, it doesn't even matter. We're in some trouble. No, you're not. You're mildly poisoned. You're about to do 196 damage to this bug. You're actually fine. Oh, you want to bond with a Sawaddle? Too fucking bad. I have standards even if you don't. Okay, oh, I think I do just need to... Yeah, dude, just splash. Have a great time. I don't know if using its move every turn does anything. Ooh. Like, I don't know if using its move every turn or taking damage increases Link. Yeah, up your defense. It's not going to help. I mean, considering the enemies are so much tougher here, it is possible that it's just strength alone. Just kind of what I hope. Because they got a good amount of Link from that. What's happening to Starly? Ooh, yes, yes. Give me a Staravia. Please. I'd love one of those. Bukidon Starly has evolved into Staravia. Love that for you. It's a very heartening development. Is that a gold star connection that you two have? Yeah, what's your... Right, your specialty is steel, which we don't have, and I don't know how to check. Ah, okay, so that's a basic bitch connection. That's like a, you don't even want to be here. You start with a gold. Okay. So yeah, that's just like a, this was my starter. But I hated my starter because instead of getting a fantastical gift from a Pokemon professor, I had to wrestle it in the woods to gain its strength. Okay. Very specific, but that's the vibe that I do get from this game a little bit. Right, train that Ralts up. Sorry. But yeah, I recently sold, actually today, this morning, sold a whole bunch of my, DS games and stuff, the physical copies that I had, so I am now officially basically only handling. Cool. Basically only doing emulated stuff now, which is fine. I made sure I had emulated versions of all the games, which will prove to be great because I will probably play most of them on, you know, on the channel at some point. Although, two of them I'm gonna have to get a little creative with. If any of you have ever played Fossil Fighters, you know that the touchscreen was like a really big part of the mechanics of that game. Like, if your touchscreen didn't work, you were fucked. Like, if a portion of your touchscreen was fucked up, like, you had to put your trust in the gods of gaming. Because you needed to, like, clean fossils well to get strong dinosaurs so that you could, like, win. The cleaning was actually my favorite part of the game, because you give me a tedious task, and that will be my favorite thing in the world. Like, I will do anything for a tedious task. I guess you can chill here. So yeah, the cleaning was my favorite part. But yeah, you need, like, you know, delicate surgical precision sometimes. And even then, sometimes it wasn't enough, especially in Fossil Fighters Champions, to, like, clean the fossils correctly. So that, I'm thinking I might... This feels so silly, but I might have to actually set up my art tablet so that I can do that. And that would be fun. The other one is, of course, Pokemon Ranger. Pokemon Ranger is also one of my favorite game series of all time. It is just... Like, I couldn't even describe what the core appeal was. I think it was just... One of my favorite things about Soul Silver was having the Pokemon walk around with me. And I've always sort of been interested in, like, the idea of a Pokemon game where you're just, like, a Pokemon Ranger or something, like a Safari Zone Warden is always the thing that I, like, think about the most. So I feel like having a more, like, naturalistic, so much connection to your Pokemon was something that, like, as a kid, I was like, yeah, I'm all about this. This is my favorite game series of all time, except for Pokemon Mystery Dungeon, which was just... incredible. Pokemon Ranger, I don't feel like was as good with the storytelling as Mystery Dungeon, but then again, what is? Dang, I was really hoping that would do it for Venipede, but... Alas. Sorry. But alas... Fossil Fighters isn't, like, so good on the storytelling either. Like, it's a fun game. It just doesn't tug your heartstrings the same way that Explorers does. Which, like I said, you know, really, what else in Pokemon does that? I guess there were some points in Moon that definitely did that for me. Gladion and Lily's sort of everything was, Yep. Yeah, the rest of you can just train. I don't really care. Okay. Now I am concerned about the aggressiveness of these guys. Especially because we are technically weaker than them, like in terms of sheer numbers. Ooh, an Onix might be fun when there's a Scraggy there. Okay. What's going on in Cresselia? Because so far I feel like Cresselia has been a bit dull. A Chingling. Ooh, that could be fun. I'll go for the Chingling. Now it's a psychic type, and I really need like a dark type is the issue. And in terms of like recruitables, it's not really that great is the annoying thing. Like, so far this place hasn't produced much good in the way of like things I can recruit. Gotta be a little bit more careful here. So, you've got a quick attack too. Are you serious? That's absurd. Why do neither of you? Oh, Jagged Edge is so much better than Poison Point. For me, not for them. Yeah, okay, you've got Wing Attack. Think I'll send you over there. And I'll send you over here. Yeah, just have a little splash around. You sit in the corner, sweetie. Fire Fang plus two. Ooh, that's a damn good Fire Fang. Can I run up on you? I can. Grass Cloak will not save you. I'm sorry, Swaddle. It simply will not. Now that that's out of the way, I can get to the real meat of it, which is my Chingling. I say my Chingling. It's not mine yet. But soon. Okay. So I'm gonna have you deal with this at the moment. You don't do much damage, but that's actually fine because I don't really need you to. Like, I don't particularly care about that. Okay, you know what? I'm just gonna handle this. Thanks. Cool. Trico, why don't you come up here and grab this? Soft clay. What's your warrior skill? Just raises your defense, huh? Just have a little splash, Magikarp. Have a good time. Jaramuka doesn't move fast enough to really get all the way where it needs to go. Ooh. I should not have moved my Trico up. That's fine, I'll just move him back. Oh! Okay. You've moved back to get your ass kicked by my Jaramuka. Understandable. It's fun for the whole family. Ooh, yeah, increased chance of critical hits. Let's do that. Yeah, you did your best, bud. Oh yeah. Have a little splash. Once again, I don't know if this does anything. Alright. Fire against fire isn't the best, but I don't care about recruiting this guy, so it's fine. Actually, I'm gonna have Darmuka do his little run up first. Sorry. Oh, if it faints to the equivalent of a trap kill, I don't think it will join us. Okay, good, good, good. It was me that did that. Too good. That's a hot sailor guy. I didn't even notice that. Which is weird for me, because usually I do acknowledge the hotness of my enemies at all times. Just sort of when it's relevant, which is always. Alright. 30 gold. Let's just handle this, man. I don't need to tell Magikarp to do another splash. Let's just handle this. I think I already have the ugly monkey, so I'm not going to recruit it. I at least have one of the ugly monkeys. Two? I think I've got the water and the grass, and I don't need the fire. Yeah, that's great. Shoot, where should I put him? I don't actually think it's strong enough to go there. No, I do not want to dismiss him. I want to place him in that castle. Okay. I know technically this is delegated, but... Okay, it's just a Joltik and a Shinx, yeah. Delegate, yeah. No. Duh. Yeah, just trying. Okay. Pugilus. Oh. That's my dad about to go to bed, so... This will probably be... our last round. Of training. Hopefully they don't, attack me and make... Yeah. Hello. Oh, good night. Sleep well. Why is my door locked? I do not remember locking my door. Sometimes when I'm tired, my brain just does dumb shit on autopilot. Yes, I don't know if he heard me, so I'll just text him. I meant to press the other button. Whatever. So, I can actually hit the Onyx from here, I think. Yeah. And the Onyx is the only thing I can hit, so I'm going to. Ooh, that was a crit. That's nice. They put you at the worst possible place to get anything done. Oh, that's right. I should actually be checking to see if anybody's interested in, Scrafting? I don't remember the name of that Pokemon, even a little bit. Occasionally breaks during use. Not interested. Let's keep that potion. Interesting choice, not choosing any of the normal types that are like 5 milliliters away from you, but okay. I'm not gonna argue. Instinct. Okay. Oh shit. Right, I forgot rock is good against Sveals. Yeah, that's not strong enough to really be worth the effort. Yeah, you know what? Fall back on that one. Oh, hang on. What's your warrior skill? Ooh, increases range and makes enemies flinch. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna see if I can make this Onyx flinch. Ooh, I froze it. That's just as good. Nice, fuck you, Venipede. Wonderful. Dang, this is really the farthest you can go? Okay. Oh good, it does have a wing attack. I haven't been checking to see if people want a Scrafty. you don't have to be them. Okay, nobody wants it. I can destroy it without mercy. Alright. That's it nearly gone, so I might as well just do it. Oh, if I had done it with the Eevee, I could have moved and also hit the... Pansage? Yes. Pansage, as in... the herb. I love not having a singular brain cell. Just like this Pansage. Then again, it's not working with much. What are you gonna do? Nothing at the moment. I'm just gonna sort of vibe. Anyways, out of my way, man. Or actually, I can't. So we'll just have to do 72 damage from here. A disappointment, to be sure, but... Oh no, Jagged Edge, whatever shall I do? Anyways... Think I can hit it from here? Yeah. I love its evil little laugh. It's so fun. Right, I'm actually gonna grab me and do this because I'm pretty sure Rufflet's about to handle that Pansage. So we can just sort of clean up the rest. Oh no, it might be too short. It was not too short. Okay, I was like, the Onyx can't be recruited? No, I'm just dumb and can't read. Goodbye, everyone else. I just want the Onyx. It's great. Where should I put ya? Cecilia's full, Violet's full. I guess I'll dump you in Ignis. What is happening to... Yes, please. Please give me a good Pokemon. Give me a Curlia. Love that for her. Smelt has evolved into Curlia. His daily devotion and diligence that has made this possible. So true, bestie. Always have not been delegated tasks have completed their turns. Yeah, let's end the month. Oh, they have been training. Every time it snaps to them, I get so fucking nervous. Alright, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna see what's waiting for us. And then I'm going to... quit. Okay, same old, same old. Ooh, there's a warlord here. Yes, okay, it is a warlord, not just like a helper. Okay, that would be great. I would like to recruit him. And, oh, there's a singular Pichu. That's not really ideal. Is anybody I should move out of Pugilis? I think Carnivine's so powerful that even though they're fire types, I think I should risk it. Okay. It is better than Qingling now that it is evolved, although before I could have swapped it with Qingling. 146. Yeah, I don't think I'm likely to really find anything better. So I've just got a train. Oh. No, okay, this Carnivine is better. was. I was like, oh, hang on. Maybe I should now. 218, 213 for the fire types there. See, it's this feel and the Kerlia that are holding me back. I feel. I want to have all unique Pokemon, but not at the risks of losing. So what I might do is I might get rid of this feel. Honestly. I would have to replace it with an equally strong water type, and I simply don't have one of those. So I might... You're all fairly strong. What I'm going to do is I'm going to grab Soren and you. I'm going to march you two to Fontaine. I do enjoy that we have airships now, because our kingdom is so great. I love that about this game. I'm going to move you over someplace incredibly strong and just have you train there. Oh, there's a better Pelplup and Wooper there. That was foolish of me. So yeah, I'm going to move you guys to Ignis. Okay. Wonderful. So now I've got to move the Wooper over. The good one, at least. Okay. Perfect. So now I will get to the actual work of my turn, next time. Thank you so much for watching. Sorry for the noise in the background. And also for the noise it makes when it saves. Alrighty. But yeah, I put out episodes on Mondays and Thursdays when my computer allows me. I don't know how long it's going to continue doing that. Old girl is struggling. But yeah, I will see you then.